Hola, ¿qué tal? ¿Cómo estáis? ¿Bien? Me alegro. Good. So let's move on now. Let's move on to audio and video number 4 in our vocab builder for verbs. Okay, now, we're in the C's and we're going to start with the word to start. Okay. And that verb is comenzar. Comenzar or comenzar. Okay, so how easy is that? We already have the word to start, which is commence. Okay, a little tip. You'll notice this as you're learning Spanish. English comes from many, many places, but there are two very, very key roots. One is from the Latin root, and that's via French and via Latin. And one is from the Germanic root, okay? Now, what happens is many of the words that we would class as posh, okay? The words that if somebody used it, they would sound very intelligent. They tend to come from the Latin. And the more short, more common words, excuse me if you're German, you listen to this, I'm sorry, it's just the way it is. But the shorter common words are more from the Germanic, yeah? So, when you look at the word start, for example, and you can say, hey, we're going to start tomorrow. But also you could say, we're going to commence tomorrow. Now that would sound very nice, okay? But that's because it's just that word comes from Latin. It's like quiet, isn't it? If you say quiet, it's very quiet. Of course you could say it's very tranquil. But that's quite poetic and you wouldn't normally use that in day-to-day speech. But that's because tranquil comes from Latin and the posh words are Latin. There you are. So, comenzar, to commence, is to start, okay? So, then to answer. That could be to answer the phone, to answer somebody. And that is contestar. Okay, now again, we have another word that perhaps we wouldn't use in the place of answer, but that is to contest. For example, if somebody has a will and another person isn't happy about it, they can contest the will. So, to answer is contestar. So think of contesting a will, for example, answering the information in a will in a bad way. So, contestar. Next one is to cost, okay? And the verb is costar. How good is that, eh? Costar. Now, be careful, this verb is irregular, as are many, okay? And this one is cuesta, okay? If you were gonna break it down, cuesta. So costar, so you can think of cost a coffee, can't you? And think, well, a coffee costs quite a bit in costa coffee, okay? Costar. ¿Cuánto cuesta un café en Costa Coffee? I don't know. £3? £2? $3? $2? I don't know. Bueno, costar, to cost, so it's virtually the same. Then we've got to decide. To decide, okay, to make that decision, to decide. And decide is decidir. Decidir, okay? Or decidir. So, virtually the same, except you've got an ear on the end. All right, so you can think of, well, I'm going to decide here and now where I'm going to go on my summer holidays. I'm going to decide here and now. Decidir. Or decidir. Okay. And then we've got to say, okay? Oh, this is a weird one. How are you going to remember it? It's weird. To say is decir or decir, okay? Decir. Now, how you're going to remember it is think of one of these old men, you know, these old people that are always doom saying, they're always talking about stuff, bad stuff that's going to happen. And say, I tell you, there'll be death here, I tell you, I'm telling you, death here. There'll be death here. Decir, okay? To tell. To say, to tell. And then the last one is to fall asleep. Okay? To fall asleep. And that verb is dormirse. Dormirse. Okay? And just be aware that that's falling asleep. And to sleep is dormir. Okay, so the only difference is that it's got a say on the end because it's reflexive, because it's something that you do to yourself. You fall yourself asleep, bizarrely enough. Okay? Nobody else makes you fall asleep, do they? You do. So, dormirse. Now, how you're going to remember that is if you really do want to fall asleep, the best thing to do is to close the door here, yeah? Because if you don't close the door, yeah, well, there'll be too much noise. Dormir. Dormirse. To fall asleep. And dormir. To sleep. Okay. Have you got those? I think you might have. So, and don't worry, you know at the beginning, if you've just got a vague idea, you're like a vague idea of what it is, you can maybe just get the first two letters, you've got it. You have got it. All you need to do is repeat that a couple of times. And you'll have it. You see, it's all about getting what's called the hook. Okay? It's getting the hook into your brain, into your synapses, into your neural pathways. Once you've got the hook there, the hook is there, and you won't lose it. Yeah? The problem is that we try to learn things, and normally we try to learn things just by la fuerza de voluntad, no? What's it called again in English? We try to learn with our own willpower, okay? We say, I must remember that, I must remember that, I must remember. That's not a system. Just telling yourself you must remember it. The system is finding a way of hooking it into your brain so that it'll never be lost, okay? Bien. So, here we go. Comenzar. Comenzar. Is, posh word, to commence, or in other words, to start. Comenzar. Bien. Luego, contestar. Contestar. Is, maybe you're thinking about contesting a will, is to answer. Okay, to answer. Costar. Costar. Nice and easy. How much does a coffee cost? So, costar is to cost. Okay. Decidir, or decidir. Decidir, to decide here. Decide, to decide. Decidir. Mm-hmm. And then this one. Decir. Decir. I'm telling you, there's death here. Decir. So to tell, or to say. Decir. Mm-hmm. This one. Dormirse. Dormirse. Or dormir. Dormirse is, well, if you really want to go to sleep, to fall asleep, you must close the door here for the noise. Close the door. Dormirse is to fall asleep. And dormir, to sleep. Okay, well done. There you are. So, that's brought us into the E's. And on to number 5. Okay. Número 5 de los audios y los videos. Entonces, nos vemos en el próximo. Hasta luego, chicos. Que sigáis estudiando. Adiós.